Hello, this is Siddharth Tambar from Chicago Arthritis and Regenerative Medicine. It's Thursday, March 12th, 2020. We're currently in this country and really worldwide going through a pretty urgent situation that's leading to progressive levels of panic, I think, in society. And it's regarding the COVID-19 coronavirus outbreak. And I think it's important for those of us who are at the front lines, involved, have some perspective, that we start speaking up to give our perspective on things, to help lead and give assurance to the people who count on us. And what I find is that a lot of my physician colleagues and the lay people, patients, and friends that I talk to have very different perspectives in terms of what's going on. Most physicians that I talk to have a measured level of concern about what's going on, meaning they recognize this as a significant infectious event, yet they're not panicking in the sense that they recognize that while this is a viral infection that is a bit more contagious than the regular flu virus, it's also a bit more significant in terms of side effects and deaths than what you have with the regular flu virus as well. But that the level of concern is one that should be measured and not panicky. And the reason why is because, number one, I think there are very smart, dedicated professionals who are trying to help at a frontline level, whether it's physicians and nurses. At the public health level, officials at the CDC seem to be doing a sensible approach in terms of giving big picture guidelines when it comes to hand washing, avoiding large crowds, trying to minimize non-essential large-scale events, and it looks like private industry is making smart decisions as well. And I think for those of us who have a perspective in terms of what the usual baseline medical risks that we all deal with, feel like this is something that we need to handle and go through, but will be manageable over time. And that the perspective of stay calm and carry on is probably most appropriate right now. I think the challenges that we have are that we live in a time when there is a tremendous amount of media coverage that is not always very educated or on point and tends to echo itself again and again and again. We're getting messages from people who are not necessarily the most educated or knowledgeable on some of these issues. We have leadership at a higher national level that is giving a bit mixed messages as well, unfortunately. And I think just not understanding the kind of regular risks that that we have medically, even with the general flu virus, may be causing a little bit extra concern as well. With that said, I think the concern that people have that this is significant is appropriate. And the things that you should be doing as an individual should be focusing on what you can do for yourself, your family, and your community to help keep things safe and protected. And some of these things are very basic, but important to keep on doing. Obviously, number one, hand washing, right? Being very hygienic in terms of how you handle yourself and your cleanliness is essential. Make sure your kids know that as well. My six-year-old daughter, I mean, that is something we are emphasizing to her, not in an obsessive way, but in an appropriate way, is essential. Number two, I think being sensible about travel. I think doing your normal activities is still okay. You need to be careful probably with non-essential travel. I think if you have elderly parents, grandparents, or people in your family, look out for them. I had a patient today who expressed concern that he has to use public transport to go visit his family in another part of town and to get groceries. And, you know, it probably would be sensible if his family was assisting him with some of those things. He made another really interesting comment, which was that in the 1950s, he recalls that a nurse would actually come and visit weekly young kids to kind of make sure that they were doing okay. We don't really live in that kind of society any longer where we look out for each other in that kind of way. But I think looking out for your neighbors and community members is a decent and essential thing to do at this time. I think we have to get back to some of those kind of old school values as well. And I think, if you have early signs of a respiratory illness, if you have anything that resembles fevers or shortness of breath, absolutely get checked out by your trusted physician that can help make a diagnosis quickly for you. Understand that the medical facilities in this country are trained and appropriate to handle severe respiratory illnesses. And if it gets to that level, that there are ways to help assist you. I think it's also essential to remember that if you do have early signs of maybe a mild respiratory illness, whether that's some mild nasal drainage or cough, that a relative self-quarantine in terms of limiting your connection with others would probably be smart as well in this kind of case right now. And then I think the other thing is be aware of where you're getting your sources of information. I think that's really key right now. We're inundated with information, and yet we have very little value that we get from a lot of the information that we receive right now. And stick with reliable sources, whether that's your trusted physician or the CDC. Make sure you're relying on people and organizations that have a level head, an experienced perspective, and can handle your issues in a personalized and an appropriate manner. I know we're getting questions from patients about medications that they're taking, and each one of these is a personalized question and issue and can be handled in an appropriate manner. So to me, the big picture right now is stay calm, carry on, be smart, self-care, take care of each other, and we'll get through this. And hope everyone is safe and doing okay, and have a good day and live well. Bye-bye.